Few people ever got close to James Dean the person. One was his co-star and friend, Sal Mineo.
Sal, how does it feel to be standing on the same spot as that scene but 20 years later?
Well, it all comes back in flashes, in very clear flashes, but I mainly feel that the place is still filled with ghosts. I don't mean just Jimmy's ghost, but anybody who has had anything to do with the film, Natalie, Nick Adams, and Corey, and everybody, because it was an experience that I've never experienced in a film before, that that was like a family, and everybody did become very tight. And it was almost like a spiritual experience. And it's all here now. And mainly that Jimmy was the focus of it. And we all grew around him. And as a result, I think we all did look up to him. And it's here. And it's a nice feeling. And it's not a morbid feeling.
What kind of relationship did you have during the film?
I was terrified of him. I was afraid of him. And I really didn't know him at all. And gradually it grew, as it did in the film. I began to idolize him. The thing that I loved about him, and the thing that I wanted to be one day, was the way he dealt with people on people in a higher position. He would never take anything from anybody. I mean, take any nonsense from anybody. And he would stand up to them, no matter what the situation was. And I said, far out, that's what I'd like to be able to do.
We read stories now about how cruel and unfeeling James Dean could be. Were you ever the target?
I never really thought of them as being unfeeling. I always thought that there was something behind some of his actions. I mean, things like there were mornings when he really was awful to people, in that he totally disregarded them, would never say anything, or to me personally. Not a good morning, nothing for a whole day. And all of a sudden, of course, I felt rejected. I said, what did I do wrong? And that would happen with people in different areas and at different times. He was late a lot of times. It was difficult to get into a scene and, you know, those kinds of things. But eventually, of course, I was only 16 then, and I was very impressionable and very sensitive. If he didn't say good morning to me, I was a wreck that whole day. But when he did, and if he put his arm around me, that was fabulous, because then I knew he meant it. But I always felt he was testing people, testing to see how far he could push someone. And if someone stood up to him, he dug it. He respected that.
You and he have to play the dramatic climax of Rebel, which must have been a very dramatic scene to shoot, where despite his efforts to save you, you get killed. Can you remember that day?
Oh yeah, it's very clear, and it was a very important day for me, in that the scene was that I ran out of the planetarium, got shot, and Jimmy then discovers me dead and hovers over me and expresses what he feels, the grief that he feels at that moment. So he had a number of choices to make. But what I had felt, strangely enough, was that here was a chance for me to feel what it would be like for someone close, someone that I idolized, to be grieving for me, and for me to experience what kind of grief that would be. What would he be like? What would he sound like? What would he be thinking? And I wanted to do that scene over and over again. And each time we did do it, he would position me in a kind of position that would work for him to get the emotion going. And it was very moving for me, because he was very moved, and when you see the scene, you'll see how he broke up in that moment. And it was seeing your idol there expressing his grief, and that was incredible. And immediately after the scene, I noticed that there was a change in the relationship. He was very protective, and that whole day he would never let me out of his sight. He was always there, and that felt nice.
See? Come on.
Who's that?
Just a guy.
I shot up one of them.
No, it's all right. You didn't hurt him.
Those are not my friends.
Well, look.
Make them go away.
Are you on? You want me to make them go away? Want me to fix it?
Okay.
Jim!
Hey, Ray. You make those guys get back?
You don't have to worry about anything. Here, Ray, keep the guys back. Ray?
That other kid still has a gun.
No! Don't turn on the lights!
Don't. It's too bright. Plato doesn't... Please.
Turn out the lights!
Jim! Jim!
All right, Lieutenant. Hey, Jackpot. What'd you do that for?
Jackpot, hey.
Can't help it, son. You did everything a man could.
I always feel that he's there within reach and has had a good influence on my life.
Do you actually have contact with him?
I went through a period, because it was something that we had discussed too during the relationship about making contact with people that are gone, with spirits and all of that. And I tried, and a number of years afterwards, when I finally did accept the fact that he died, I tried making contact with him through sometimes a Ouija board or with a glass and that kind of thing. And I believe it happened. I believe I did feel the presence. And I believe that there was a communication. Of course, I believe that it is possible to make communication with a spirit.